This is Bethany with your Rockin' Charger Nation news, so let's get this rolling. SCS and Student Council are hosting the annual Operation Christmas Child at SHS. You can help in two ways, by packing a shoebox or bringing some supplies on the supply list. You can pick up the supply list from Ms. Hatch on A Hall, Professor Smith on B Hall, and Ms. McMahon on C Hall. Book Club will be meeting today after school in Ms. Linda Johnson's room in B107. They will be reading Rebecca by Daphne du Maurier. There will be a Divas meeting every Monday before school at 7:45 to 8:15 and after school from 4 to 5:30. Wednesday, November 12th, the Student Council will meet in Ms. Hatch's room in A111 at 7:45 to discuss prom ideas. All are welcome, but you must have a Student Council pass to attend. Today is obviously rock and roll. Tomorrow's rap and R&B. Thursday, let's throw it back to the ages. And Friday, let's spice it up with a little pop. For anybody who does not know, Pink Floyd is not a song, it is a band.
Wait, I thought Pink Floyd was a song by Nirvana.
Go in the corner. Go in the corner and think about what you just said. And let's not forget, today is Veterans Day. Here is Megan Calhoun with an insight on Veterans Day.
Today is Veterans Day. This day is dedicated in honor of the sacrifices that our veterans made and continue to make America a free country. A veteran is a person who has had a long service or experience in an occupation. One may not realize the extent of what they sacrifice. Those who serve may lose a friend or a family member. Others may lose a limb or even their life. Now that does not happen to everyone, but each veteran experienced something different. This is Andy Hamm, who served in the Navy and Air Force.
This is retired Chief Master Sergeant Andy Hamm. I'm with the United States Air Force. I spent 6 years in the Navy. I got out for about 10 years, went back into the Air Force for another total of 33 years.
Mr. Hamm.
Yes, ma'am.
What was it like to serve and have the experiences that you have?
Serving in the military is exciting at times, boring at times, frightening at times. It all really depends on what situation you're in and where you are. To be frightening was when you first joined, you have no idea what to expect. You have to rely on other people, especially your instructors, to tell you when to get up, when to go to sleep, when to eat, when to take a shower. They basically run your life until you get out of basic.
Man.
And once you get out of basic, you're again with instructors. But it's not as stringent as it was before, so you have more leeway. But being away from home, you've never been away from home before, so that's a frightening experience until you get used to it. And then it can be a very exciting experience when you find out where you're going and what you're going to be doing. So it's just all, you know, big ball of wax there. You just have all types of emotions.
What were some of the challenges you faced during and after your service?
I guess the challenges during service is being around other people that you really don't know, that you actually live with for months and months on a time. And you're on a ship, like me, I was on an aircraft carrier of 5,000 other men. And you're at the sea for 90 days at a time. And it can be boring at times, and it can be exciting at times. I think the most exciting part of it was being able to go up what we call the lookout deck. You can actually watch the airplane take off and land, and you're about maybe 45 or 50 feet away from them when they do it. And it's exciting to watch that. The other things is just sometimes it gets very boring, and you have nothing to do. There's no theater you can go to. There's no coffee house you can go to. Just sit there and watch TV or play solitary.
If you wouldn't mind, would you tell us one of your stories?
I guess the most exciting and the funniest after was over was when I was told by my drill instructor when I left Great Lakes that I was going to go to Lakehurst, New Jersey and be a parachute rigger. And I asked him, well, what does a parachute rigger do? And he says, well, you take care of all the survival equipment on the aircraft, and you jump out of an airplane. I said, no, I'm not jumping out of a perfectly good airplane. Well, I got to Lakehurst, New Jersey, went to school, and our graduation day, we had to make a parachute jump to graduate. Put my parachute on, put my helmet on, got on the airplane with 45 other men, and got to altitude, and the green light came on, the doors came open, and away we went. And you had to actually physically pull your own ripcord. So you were in free fall. I had no idea what to expect, no idea what was going on, so I jumped out the door, and I thought to myself, what am I doing here? Pulled the ripcord, parachute opened up, fine, had no problems, hit the ground. The next day, put the parachute back on, went back up in the airplane, got to the door, and I froze. I looked out there and I says, wait a minute, I know what's going to happen now. Before I could say two words, the jump master behind me had his foot in my back and pushed me out the airplane.
Aww.
After that, I had a ball. I jumped almost every day for months and loved it.
If you had one lesson that you learned from your service that you would teach others, what would it be?
It would have to be to trust in your fellow man or woman, whatever the case may be, because you never know what type of situation you're going to be in. Me, I never really faced face-to-face combat, but some of the men like in Afghanistan, Iraq have, and they have to develop rapport with their men and their platoon leaders to be able to trust them. So you have to learn to trust people. When you get out, that trust is still with you, but sometimes you have to be careful of who you trust. But in the military, you have to be able to trust almost everyone.
If you see someone who is serving or has served, be sure to thank them, not only just today, but every day.
This has been Bethany with your Rockin' Charger Nation News. I'm rolling out.